Hi guys, today I want to discuss briefly Silver's point of view about the fight being perfect only with the blow and the thrust, and the fact that rapiers are inferior to backswords. Now, in Silver's time, rapiers were too long, too heavy and unwieldy. However, what if we consider rapiers of perfect length? So let's compare a backsword to some other weapon with more or less the same blade length. Let's talk about reach first. If I pick up the backsword, my hand is well protected, I had the blow and the thrust, but due to the shape of the hilt, my hand cannot bring the point exactly in line with the forearm. And also, some rapiers, we will see, have a reach advantage that is due to the shape of the grip itself. So, I will stand at a fixed distance and show you my reach with various weapons. So I have installed something that will help me demonstrating the reach of the various weapons. I will stand at a fixed distance. Let's start with the backsword. I'm close to reaching the barrel, but I don't actually reach it. Okay? Saber. Things will go a little bit better. I can touch it. Barely. An Italian spada or rapier with a blade of the same length as that of the saber, okay? They basically are just as long. But I can go past the barrel by some centimeters. French-shaped rapier, or epe. I can go past the barrel by some centimeters. And as you know, the thrust is effective from here, not from here. So I'm already into the target, okay? So, the two rapiers, the Italian and the French, have a reach advantage over the saber, which has a reach advantage over the backsword. Now, let's consider other factors. It is true that this type of rapier doesn't cut. So, its fight is imperfect. But, what is my end speed for pairing a thrust with the backsword? Simple parry, mezza contro parry, contro parry or circular parry. What's my end speed for delivering a thrust with a disengagement? Cavazione. Double cavazione. Circolata. I can actually outmaneuver myself by changing the weapon. With the short rapiers of the 18th and 19th century, I can outmaneuver myself with the backsword. Things don't change much if I switch to Saber. I'm a bit faster with a simple parry. Mezza contro parry and contro parry. But still, I cannot really compete with the end speed I have with the rapier. So I can actually outmaneuver myself with a cut and thrust weapon using a thrusting weapon. So, what advantage does the backsword or saber user have? He has the cut. And with the cut, he is going to try to hit me in the arm from far away because he doesn't want to close with my point. However, if I have a sturdy and big cup, this is going to take care of the problem, because if I can oppose the cup to the cuts and counter thrust as my opponent is cutting at my forearm, I can hit him before he can hit me. So, honestly, I understand that the, having the cut and the thrust is a, is an additional bonus, and that in Silver's point of view, only with the cut and the thrust the fight is perfect, but the fact that the fight is perfect doesn't mean you will win the fight, because specialized weapon has some bonuses of its own and can outmaneuver the cut and thrust weapon and outreach it in some circumstances. So if you are using a thrusting only weapon that is well built, in my opinion, you are not necessarily going to lose to somebody who is using a backsword or a saber. Much less a backsword, because his reach is even shorter than the saber's. Thanks for watching, guys.